as long as oil is cheap, plastic isn't going anywhere. There is a big responsibility that we have to the oceans, in my opinion, to figure out what these actual effects are on even smaller scales than just animals eating plastics. The majority of plastic pieces are so small that they're really hard to see. They might blend in with sand, but those are also the pieces of plastic that we know the least about. So there's this big world of, you know, what's going on not just a physical level, but also the chemistry of the plastic, because no two plastics are created equal. And it's this really huge problem that has been around for a while, and there's certainly been research done, but we're not anywhere near where we need to be in understanding it.
We got interested in plastics research because we'd seen that horrible movie, and it was a movie that they showed us where a bird was pecking along the beach and pecking through all kinds of plastic and showing you what the bird had left on the beach and the plastic in his droppings. That's how I got interested. We just thought it would be such a great idea to get to the bottom of it. VIMS has been in our family for quite a while. My husband got involved with VIMS, I guess, probably 20 some years ago. I told the children that I thought VIMS might be a place we should be because we're all interested in the bodies of water that we have right around us.
The Freeman family recognized that one of the major problems we have in our waterways, not just Chesapeake Bay, but in our coastal ocean, is with marine plastics. They are a danger to marine life, they are unsightly, and they can actually introduce toxic substances into the environment that we really don't want in this particular environment. And we think even potentially can create human health effects. So this very generous support from the Freeman family is allowing us to break new territory, move ahead in new ways, and it's really going to take us very effectively into the future.
The more that we can do, even on a day-to-day basis, just talking to people about the plastic issues so that maybe they're more aware of what's going on and maybe make different choices in their day-to-day lives, that would be something that would make a big difference in the way people think about not only their plastic use, but also the oceans and how they respond to what we're doing to them.